Hello to everyone, my name is Daniel, and I'm going to talk about my favorite number. There are many YouTubers that are making now the hashtag MegaFabNumbers, and I wanted to try it, so I will explain my favorite number, the best one. The number that I like most is 100 unbintillion, 669 bingintillion, 616 noendecillion, 553 octodecillion, 523 septendecillion, 347 sexdecillion, 122 quindecillion, 516 quartodecillion, 32 tridecillion, 313 duodecillion, 645 undecillion, 505 decillion, 168 nonillion, 688 octillion, 116 septillion, 419 sextillion, 19 quintillion, 768 quadrillion, 627 trillion, 200 billion. Why this number is the best one? I'm going to explain that. It starts with this little Rubik's Cube. You may know it is one of the most solved toys in the world, and it is really impressive how much math you can learn about this. First of all, how many permutations, how many possible combinations you can make with this cube. You can turn left, right, up, down, many things you can do with this cube. And the impressive number is that you can make more than 43 quintillion possible combinations. That's a really big number. And you may think, where does this come from? How is the question that tells me that this can be 43 quintillion, no 1 billion, 10 moves? Well, it's better to start with a little one. So now to explain why those numbers are generated, we can start with this little formula. 8 factorial times 3 to the power of 7 over 24. This explains how many possible permutations we have with this little cube. But you may start why. What means those factors? First, the 8 factorial. It means that we have 8 corners in the cube. 4 here and 4 here. This means that we have 8 possible combinations at start, and it can be factored because are the combinations of how we can arrange the different possible of this corners. And then we have the 3 to the 7 power. This is how many possible arrangements has each of one corner. Each corner has 3 colors, so it can be looking black up, white up, white left, or white front. And this is to the power of 7 because it can only be 7 possible different combinations. Because the 8 one, when we establish these other 7s, the 8 one is located in exact point and we can change it because there's no algorithm to change the only one corner on the cube. Then it appears 24. As this cube doesn't have any centers, the possible orientation of the first corner that can be the 8 corners by the 3 possible combinations, that it's 3 times 8, that it's 24, are divided because we don't have an idea of how the cube will be arranged. It is looking upwards, downwards, front, left, right. So we can eliminate all these permutations and we get with this number 3,674,360 that are the possible combinations of the 2x2 cube. Then we go to the 3x3 cube. Now we have the 3x3 cube. As you can see, the equation for the number of permutations is really similar, but the difference is this second term. The first part is the same. 8 corners in the cube, 3 different ways to arrange each corner. The 8th corner will always be mandatory arranged by the last one. So then we achieve this part, the 12. 12 to the power, it's how many edges we have. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 here, 5, 6, 7, 8, here, and over 4 we have 12 in total, and they can be arranged in only 2 ways, or white or orange. So this means that 2 to the 11, as I explained before, 11 is the same as 7, that we only have to arrange 11 of them, and the last one will be also arranged. And as you can see, we also have a 2 dividing. But what you ask is, this is a part of the theory of groups, that there can be even or odd groups. The idea of the cube group is that the permutations and the groups must have to be even. So in order to have that, the permutations we have here can be divided by 2, can be even. So we divide by 2 here. This is a total of 4.33 times 10 to the 19 power. That means that the possible combinations of here are like million of times bigger than the last one, because this is so much bigger. Last one was 1 million, this has 10 to the 19. That's a quintillion. That's why the Rubik's Cube is so impressive, because we have a lot of different combinations that we can make.
Now you'll be saying, okay, well, you told us 2 numbers. One that's really big. 4 times 10 to the 19 power is really big, but where does the other number come from? The other one that I said start. It is like a lot bigger. It is 6.14 × 10⁻⁸. It's millions of times bigger than the other number. And then this number comes from this cube, my favorite cube, the Megamix. This cube is a dodecahedron. It has 12 faces, 13 centers, 30 centers, and 20. How do you say that shit? 20 corners. This means that the numbers that you can use in the equation, and you can use a really similar equation to this one, because as you can see here, this cube has 6 faces. This has 12 faces. It's the double. This has the real same pieces, like 3 pieces on the edges, like this one, 3 pieces on the edges. So we can think that we can use the same equation, and that's what we're gonna do to see how we can get this awesome number.
Here, the next equation, one about the Megamix. This is really impressive because here the numbers go really high exponentially, because now the cube, instead of having 8 different corners, it has 20 corners. This means that the factorial is increased by a lot. Then we have the same amount of numbers that we can arrange each corner, only 3 different possible ways, and then is to the power of 19, as I said before. The 2 here is because of what I explained before, the odd and even. The odd and the even possible combination of the group. In here, as you can see, as in, we increase a lot the amount of corners we have to also increase the amount of possible negated, as one way to say it, a combination we have divided by 2, meaning that the next group that we're creating is even. Then we arrive here, the 30 different edges. This cube has not only your edges, the 12, it has 30, so the factor is increased. It has 30 edges and the possible 2 outcomes of each edge. This means that I have 29, and this is roughly 1.012 × 10�68. That's a lot, and that's the number I said before. This is the best number because it explains how coming from little different cubes, we can achieve bigger numbers only with the combinations and basic zooms like left, right. This is awesome, and that's what I think about the perfect of the math explaining in the cubes and mathematical logic in the algorithms that we placed in solving these cubes.
This was a really interesting idea for a video. You should try it, making a number searching. I really didn't know how many permutations you had with this cube, but it was my first favorite, so I tried to learn. And I really learned a lot about this topic because of searching. I learned a lot about combination, permutations, factorials and that stuff. So I really recommend you to try making these things. It's really fun because you can learn about the math. You may be thinking math is like boring sometimes, but it's not. You can implement it numbers in everything you see. So you can finally like learn something about the math, about how math appears in a real world. So I hope you try this at home. This is really fun. This video is like a little bit I tried to make, but I hope you enjoy it. I learned something new, and I hope you can do this also. See ya!